those delightful last little notes as we get ready for our Friday night extravaganza. That is your 60-ish minute roundtable discussion that goes behind the scenes at RivalCast Media. It's RCM on tap! We're back, baby! Woo! All right. For those of you who haven't been around for a while, no, I'm not going to warn Sam Miesa. Shame on you. I am the Baroness. And this is RCM on tap. And I am about to let loose on... You know what? I think I just might leave the guys muted for a little while because they're picking on me again. Let me show you the video. There you go. This is what we do every Friday night. You know, when Killer's not off killing things in Tejas, but we'll talk about that in a minute. I am Jen. Joining me, as always, Biomed Alchemist and Killer McCoy. And in fourth chair, making his grand return, the Burrito King himself, Scott Alvarado. Welcome back, sir.
I'm already on my second drink of the night.
Good.
All I can say,
there you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, is get your pull on. That's all I can say.
You're on tap. You're going to need them tonight.
All right. I'm drinking from lightest in clarity to darkest in clarity, so it should be more interesting as we go on. I started with a red strawberry ale.
Nice.
Nice. Oh,
okay.
Yep. I am now down to a shiner.
Okay.
That'll be going really fast. Then I will be going on to my actual favorite still to this day, which is Not Your Father's Root Beer.
Couldn't care for it.
Really, stop it. Shut your mouth.
I tried it. It wasn't bad. I think it was, for me, it was the aftertaste.
But people say that, and I will say, and Baroness is like frowny face.
I've had it. I thought it was fantastic, but
no,
much better. Good. Learn from her. All I can say is it is the best root beer flavored hard alcohol on the market. It is better than like Best Damn or any of the other shit ones. It really is the best flavor. And I'm getting frowns from Biomed now.
The frown face is floating around.
I'm looking at something else here.
Then I go down to my local favorite, which is Uncommon Stout. I will bring some of this with me to RivalCon.
Sweet.
So, hey, everybody out there, please, please, please come to RivalCon. Come see me. Come see Far Afield. Come see all these wonderful people here, too. But I will bring Uncommon Stout. This thing has won so many awards. It is brewed locally here in the Quad Cities. It is a coffee stout. It is fan-freaking-tastic. There's about three or four coffee stouts which are drinkable on the market. This is by far the best. You can get this on tap at a bar in almost anywhere in the Quad Cities right now, but there are two bars at Bent River Brewery. I don't work for them. I don't have anything else to do. This is a really good beer.
Just sponsored, is this like an advertisement or something?
Just put a big banner. Sponsored content.
It really is good. If you like stouts, or you like especially coffee stouts, it is very good. I will bring some with me.
Perfect.
I'll bring some with me to share.
There
so.
You go.
I will definitely try that, sir.
Perfect.
Now that we've got our booze in us.
And we got our shameless plug for RivalCon in within the first 5 minutes of the show. Good job, Scott.
Hey,
and now,
people.
Now that we've said that, I need to clear up the air about something here. It's been going around the RivalCast community. It's been a rumor involving me and five members of the Japanese pop idol group, AKB48, and I'd just like to say...
Bio, you're the one who started that rumor.
I did not have sexual relations with those women.
You are the one who started that rumor. How can you go on air on your own show to...
Well, I'd like to just say these allegations are blatantly false.
Again, you're the one who started the allegations. Nobody else did this. This was all you.
I expected better of my opponent.
How many of them are there? Are there really eight? Are there, like, more?
There's, like, a whole bunch of them.
Which he did not have sexual relations with them.
But I did not.
But he should have.
I've not with any of these.
Because, you know, it's
these are false rumors. And
not illegal.
Be vindicated.
It's not illegal in Japan. It's just frowned upon. You're just a dirty old man.
It's just frowned upon.
Hey, no, it is.
I
have several friends who live in Japan who do Teach for America, four different ones I went to college with, and all of them have tried to get me to come over to Japan, like, come to Teach for America, because they'll fucking love it. Here's this big fat guy with lots of random-ass fucking ideas, big-ass beard, he looks like the fucking Wendy's girl with his bright orange hair, and you know what, these, like, nine-year-old Japanese girls will love you. And I go, really, that's what I need in this world, is nine-year-old Japanese girls.
Holy crap, we just made a new anime or a manga.
Pretty much, it's just
been walking around.
I'm
sharing with the other guys that discovered there is an anime that just got announced that they're making the anime. The manga's been out for a while, but it's about a girl, 15-year-old girl, who falls in love with a physically matured fifth grader.
Ooh.
So it looks like someone her age, and it's like, I'm in the fifth grade. It's just like
the
really
older woman syndrome in grade school.
Robin the cradle.
In grade school.
Wait, I'm trying to remember, what age is fifth grade again?
It's like a 10, 11.
Yeah, around 10, 11
range. But literally, if she just waited like, 7 or 8 years, it'd be perfectly fine.
Well, remember, the other girl
based
was...
Based on his maturing, he may, get pretty old.
Yeah. Also, she's 14, so that's like half her lifetime. She has to wait.
Not that Brad Pitt movie or like Reverse 8. No.
The Benjamin Button thing?
Yeah, no.
No, here, I'll link it.
Don't do it.
Here.
We don't want it.
You know
I didn't want to see it the first time.
No, I don't know. I'm open. AK-48 was better than I thought it would be, too, and I looked at that link, so.
Mm. Yeah, but this is... Yeah. So, yeah. I deny these allegations. I intend to fight them.
Bubba says it doesn't sound like you at all because you hate Asians.
What?
That's hate speech.
That is hate speech, sir. It will not be tolerated.
Sammy Asa points out, but pop groups tend to be underage girls. That tends to be true, but not in every case.
No, these are kind of, I will grant this, they're in the 20 range. 20s. Just saying.
Where are these comments coming in from, Baroness? You really need to plug this shit more shamelessly than that.
Everybody who's watching this is in the chat anyway.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. Anyone who's watching this right now is on... the Twitch channel, so that's where it's going live. So if you...
Oh! Porkchop just popped in.
There.
Porkchop just popped in.
Yeah, so
look
you...
what you did. You brought the riffraff in.
So
we did.
Porkchop is a loyal listener to RCM on Tap. In fact, he was on our show just last week.
Yes.
It was totally last week. Yeah.
And you've needed to bring me here just to cleanse the palate. I understand. I know. Take that, Porkchop.
We should probably mention... since it's been a while, in case you haven't read the screen because you were too fascinated looking at our talking heads going back and forth with one another, Scott is one of the co-hosts of the Sunday night podcast on RivalCast, Far Afield, with Porkchop Hawaii.
When The Walking Dead is not on.
When The Walking Dead is not on, yes. Yes. Although you guys have been doing pretty consistent Sunday shows for the last...
doing shorter ones.
Yeah.
It saddens me.
But, I mean,
it really
still...
saddens me. That's actually Seo's idea, believe it or not. I don't know. I brought this idea up like a year and a half ago. Like, do one freaking up. Because for people who don't know, never listen to our show, we usually do like a 3-hour like extravaganza bullshit.
Right.
And it's hard scheduling wise. And I mentioned to sales, like, if we're going to do a fucking 3-hour long thing, let's just cut it up. Make it 2 45-minute ones, 3 45-minute ones, whatever makes the most flow.
Yeah.
Chop it up. And that way you can put one out every week. Because I know we had problems with people going, are you on this week? Are you not on this week? Our schedules will get jacked up, and that screwed it up even more.
Mm-hmm.
So just put something out in the stream that way. So, you don't even really have to lie. You just say it was recorded on whatever date and just split it up. So we've gone to this, and I really think they're just punishing me for watching The Walking Dead.
Yeah,
probably. Pretty much.
It makes me mad, but, whatever.
But I will say, and go ahead and plug this part, too. You have to go to the YouTube channel to watch it. I don't know, we may talk about Twitch again. I know one of the issues was that you guys are better targeted towards YouTube because there's a wider audience. Twitch is mainly
gaming,
game streaming and stuff. So people pop on, they're just like, you guys are talking about Iowa. Like, I don't get it.
Neither do we.
Yeah. But I happen to love the show quite a bit, so I listen to it every week.
Well, I'm glad we have a fan. I'm glad. If it's on our own network.
It's interesting.
A fan.
Yeah, on your own network, yeah. No, it's always been interesting to me because, so for example, the last time we had you on, you and Seo were both on at the same time.
The Wayback Machine, right? Totally Wayne.
Last time on RCM on Tap. You guys were talking about, like, you're going into stories about student council and college and all this stuff. It's just,
how I met him.
It's
yeah.
interesting stuff.
You know, I think, if I remember right, I left off with how he met his wife, right? I think that's where the cliffhanger where I left it off was.
Yeah. I think that may be it. But
and we're not going to resume that now either, so.
No, probably. Never.
And for like our audience, it's normally just comes in to like watch people play games and stuff. They're just like, oh, that's boring. But for someone like me, it's like, no, tell me more. What happened next?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I listen to it because it helps me with the backstory for fanfic stuff. That's why things are so believable, is like I can get to the essence.
Wow.
Just saying.
I should be worried. I haven't actually read any of the fanfiction parts, so that kind of scares me a little bit.
Well, you guys aren't in it until book three anyway, so...
As long as I kill a zombie.
Well, we held off because Bio was working on the side story that I didn't forget about. Just saying. But it's starting to all come back around, and I'm excited. I mean, we're finishing up Agents of Arachnos. Killer was kind enough to give me a little bit of extra time to work on that, and then that'll be wrapping up in the next week or so, and then we're the new one should... I thought it was going to be late summer, but it's looking more like late fall to do it right. But it's exciting. I've been working on that a little bit, too, and I like how the story is going. So, fun stuff.
Now, Porkchop caused you, Killer, to spoiler alert how your week has been.
No, actually, I didn't. He didn't cause me to spoil it. I did it myself. I own up. I'll give you that. Extreme ownership.
His name is Killer. That should give you all the spoiler that you need.
Hey, there could be an adjective, or I guess it'd be an adverb attached, such as unsuccessful killer.
No.
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 Not this time.
See, the reason it's not unsuccessful, Killer McCoy, is because Killer always gets his prey. So, Killer, tell us what you were doing to celebrate my birthday last weekend.
Indeed.
Well, what I was doing is me and my father, his two brothers, and my cousin went to...
In a pear tree.
You're such a...
Went down to Texas. And we killed some hogs.
And a nice tasty ones?
We don't know yet. We actually turned in all the meat on last Monday on our way back. But we had a hunting trip. And here, literally, it was the very. I got my pig on the very first outing of the entire trip.
That's because you're efficient.
Oh yeah, that too. So for the rest of the,
I'm just picturing, like, you know, okay, because when you go on these trips, I mean, it's not like anything. It's you can do this, and then once you have your thing, you know. I'm just imagining you, like, you know, texting your girlfriend like, hey, guess what? Already got my pig. Just saying, you know, if we were pioneers, you would never starve. Hearts, Killer.
Possibly. Well, it helps that everything's, you know, kinda pre laid out for you and everything, so.
Yeah. Yeah, and being a pioneer would also help if you had LTE, right? So.
Yeah. So.
I'm trying to help you out here, Killer.
And a cooler this time.
And you're
just making it.
No, well, this time we actually got to keep the meat because, you know, this place was actually a whole lot. We all agreed that we're coming back to this place again because it was that good.
Cool.
So, no, they were. I got my pig. I was like, hey, this, you know, once you're, you know, at a designated time, come back in. They sent their own people out. They collected all the pigs. Bing, bada, boom. Get your picture taken. They start skinning it and quartering it. Oh, yeah.
So now I'm imagining that this place is run by mafia members from, you know, New York or Chicago, because they're like, you know, bada, bing, we'll take care of it. We'll take care of it.
No, it made me kind of feel sad because I was talking. I got to talk to
him. Offer it can't refuse.
No, he was just he went to the, you know, went through the army, blah blah, got out, went through college. He real business oriented guy. Like, he during college time, he didn't go out drinking. He actually did a designated driver business on the side.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So he was, you know, making money. He actually had worked at the place we were at for years with the previous owner. When the previous owner had to put it up on sale, he immediately bought it up. Been running it for the last 3 years. Like, wow, that's pretty cool. I was like, how old are you? 29. You're saying you own like 300 acres of land. You have people actually come out from all across the United States and Canada, to come hunt pigs, and you're making money, you know, just, you know, left and right.
This is technically my side business.
It's like, damn it, I just feel so inadequate right now.
Killer.
What do you do? I'm waiting on a guy to finally drill into this safe at work.
Remember, Killer, you are part of an amazing media empire in the making, and you're only 30, so
extreme
you're not
understood.
That far off.
Okay, well, I am buying a house, which is, within 5 days, I will own a house, or that huge loan.
Probably. Scott's like, wait till...
Yeah.
These other life milestones hit you. Like when you get your dog, which you will have.
Yep.
When your first ex walks out on you on Thanksgiving.
Oh,
don't worry about that one. That's coming too.
On Thanksgiving?
It's in the mortgage paperwork. You just don't read it.
What? Wow. I feel like I should hear that story.
No.
Oh my god.
No, this is a happy show. We're trying to keep people happy and not depressed.
That's for Far Afield.
Yeah. Oh.
When they listen to Porkchop.
Shots fired.
Shots fired.
Shots
for you,
fired.
Buddy.
No, we all, you know, entire family had a good time. It was quite amusing because both my uncles, the very first, you know, when they had their first shot at a pig, they both missed.
What are you hunting with?
I was using a rifle. I know. Are you talking about what weapon I was using?
Mm-hmm.
I was using a SCAR 17.
Oh, all right.
I love it. So I've gotten three pigs with it. Just one of them I actually get to eat the meat now.
Finally.
Yeah. It was really bad is, you know, they got, the uncles are really into the hunting part. And they had their very specific rifles. Like one of them's got an AR, but shoots a 6.8, you know, millimeter round. The other one's shooting a 308. He actually this time got one of those night vision capable cameras / scopes.
He can record it. Yep.
Yeah, so he recorded and also see night vision wise. And they both missed. They both missed their first shots. And the one my...
Happens.
One of the uncles missed was the one that I actually got. So it was kind of like rubbing salt
nice.
In the wound.
So can they see like your shot come across and shoot?
No,
it there?
I wish.
Oh,
I wish. That would have been amazing.
Camera, yeah.
Stole it.
I wish. It
so
was
are you gonna keep the skull like you
no,
did with the other one?
No.
Gonna give up on that?
I'm gonna give. Actually, the funny thing is, I was talking to the owner because the asshole does. You know, if you want to do get the skulls and keep them, he does that too.
Okay.
He actually I was like, oh yeah, I tried doing that, but I screwed up and everything. It started falling apart. Oh yeah, I did the same thing too. You over-bleached it. I left mine over, you know, overnight. You're only supposed to do it for an hour. I left mine, like, for, like, 3 or 4 days.
Yeah, you did yours for a while.
Yeah, so, like, okay, I don't feel too bad about it. I fucked up. Other people have fucked up.
Sure.
So, yeah.
Now we know for next time, Killer.
Exactly.
I was about to say, I'm surprised you didn't just go ahead and try it again with that knowledge.
It would have been extra money.
I mean for you to do it, since you had the extra.
Well, it would have been extra money from them. It would have been extra work to keep the skull. Because my dad also got his own.
So for them to, gotcha.
Well, we didn't have enough room in the cooler for both my pig and my dad's pig. Because he got a sow that was like about 115 pounds. And I got a 145 pound boar.
See.
Quite a bit of meat.
Delicious meat.
Indeed.
We shall soon find out.
Yes.
See, what I heard just now is that you didn't have enough confidence that you would both get.
Oh no!
The big ones.
No.
So.
Oh no. We just had a really small cooler.
That's what I'm saying. You should have anticipated just coming home with tons and being prepared.
You know
to
what
stock your new home.
Overcompensating for something. That's what it was. You know, people bringing the biggest cooler.
Although
the city slickers.
No. I made two batches of jerky this time because
I don't
want to
hear about this because you
yes,
didn't
you
send
do.
Any
no, you
up
to.
Here.
I'm listening.
Do it.
No, it was just basically Because last time we went to Alabama with them, it was like, they literally devoured one bag of jerky, which was like...
That's because it's like manna from the heavens.
Crack. It's crack cocaine.
It is.
It's crack cocaine.
It is. I've told you the story before about how I took some with me when I was at a community college event. Uh-huh. And because I always take little snacks because I don't get... When I'm at an event, I'm usually there the entire day. And I don't get... it's just me. So, like, other reps, they'll have, like, two. So, like, one can go and have lunch while the other one mans the table. I don't have anybody else to do that. So I just bring little snacks with me to kind of keep me going. And then I'll go and I'll eat afterwards. But I took a little... because Killer had sent me, like, a box of jerky. And I took a little bit of it with me. And I was just kind of... You know, you don't have it out on the table. You want to be professional. So I had it kind of tucked underneath the table. And there was a big... the tablecloth in front of it, so nobody could see it. And I just, you know, nibble a little bit here and there. So, oh my god, it was so good. But people would be like walking by my table and like stopping and like, what is that smell? That is an amazing smell. And I'm like, I have no idea. Keep walking. Keep walking. I'm not sharing.
Oh yeah. No, there was actual other hunters there, as I said. We actually had a guys from Nebraska and New York, you know, New York and stuff like that. It's like
Nebraska's the worst.
Is it?
Border war.
I understand. Not really. All right. No, actually, kind of do understand what
we're Tejas.
Yeah, Tejas.
Oklahoma being Tejas's hat. Yes. Yes. Even lights would go at it all the time. South Oklahoma. Yeah.
Anyway. So I let other people try out my jersey. Like, oh my god, this is really good. Every single person.
It's amazing. The same. Set up a. Does Etsy allow people to sell cooked?
I don't know.
Foodstuffs. Just saying, Killer's like there's beef jerky service.
I thought about it. I really have, but it takes a lot of time.
I mean, you'd get into state regulations, I'm sure. Yeah. I know. What was it? I think New Jersey. They had like they're fighting to be able to sell baked goods.
And really?
Because yeah, New Jersey. As far as I know, you're not allowed to sell home baked goods.
Well, it's a mob state.
Yeah.
Say no more.
Break your legs.
Yeah. Big little Girl Scout legs. You can't sell those without a little bit of protection money.
Wait. Girl Scout can legs. You can't sell those.
Oh.
That makes sense.
Bob has that wrapped up too.
However, in Colorado, a Girl Scout can sell in front of a marijuana dispensary, and I just think that's brilliant.
That is brilliant.
They should get their business merit badge. Just for
although I smell collusion there.
There probably is. There probably
just a little
is.
Bit.
A little
kickback money.
Kind of like the South Park episode where they did that and they had KFCs everywhere.
Yeah.
See, I always thought when they first passed that they should totally do like an app for a delivery snack food service. So you just like pick all the stuff you want that's on the truck and, you know, pay with PayPal or something so the money's in your pocket.
Mm-hmm.
And you just drive up with a box, just like Amazon, just drop a big box, be like, here you go, have fun.
But overall, yeah, we all had a good time.
Very nice. Very nice.
Yeah. So. Yeah.
So
Baroness, what have you done?
I was about to ask you the same thing, and then you chimed in.
I beat you to it, so.
I know. I'm trying to remember what all I did last weekend because I slept quite a bit.
Did you?
I did.
That's the great birthday celebration.
I did.
Sleeping in.
I did. I turned 32, so I mean, having a day to take a nap is like an amazing thing for me.
Youngins.
Indeed.
He just knows the proper being proper man asleep is a good thing.
You got to remember that I don't sleep that much. And anyone who pays attention to my Twitter feed or when my posts go up, I mean, I'm up late into the evening and then I'm up early to take care of RivalCast stuff before I go to my day job. And then I'm there all day. And I mean, I don't sleep a whole lot, so the fact that I had a couple of days where that was what I was mostly doing and it wasn't because I was sick is pretty amazing. So Friday while Killer was off killing things, I went and had lunch with an old friend, and it was a really cool time. And I don't remember what else I did that day. Yes, I do, because I got my passport renewed, and then I wrote my article for the yep. Accidental Podcaster about it. Because
yeah.
I had an epiphany when I was getting my passport done. So you can read all about that.
Yeah, I liked it.
On the RivalCast
Media
homepage.
Check it out on the front page.
Yes.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm just thinking, like when you said I had a friend, lunch with an old friend. All I was thinking was Silence of the Lambs at the very end. I can see, imagine this Baroness with the outfit that Hannibal was wearing.
I'm having an old friend for lunch.
Actually,
does it involve fava beans?
Considering where he works, that's actually kind of creepier than I had intended it to be, but yeah.
What industry?
He's an IT guy, but he works for a college that does it's a like pre-med, and they do specialized like specifically it's like their school does podiatry, like foot doctory stuff.
Oh, okay.
And they have a lab in their basement. I got the whole tour of the campus. It was really actually kind of neat. I got to see all their little like not just the dummies, but they have like the simulated bodies that students work on before they're allowed to work on, you know, mm-hmm. real people, or you know, and they have a cadaver lab in the basement, which we couldn't go into, but we got to peek through the windows. So yeah, it kind of it's topical. It's topical.
It relates. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I did that. I got my passport.
I thought you were gonna say it was like a mortuary school.
That would be kind of cool though.
No. It'd been a cooking school. That's what it would have been.
A cooking school next to a mortuary school? Killer, you're just it's just getting creepy or now.
Bobby Flay is like a guest instructor at the mortuary school. That would do it.
The girlfriend made me watch the Worst Cooks of America.
So
Bobby Flay would be a pretty cool guy to be like stuck in a like random area with like, you know, no hope of survival. Like, oh, I got Bobby Flay here. So what are we having on the grill tonight? You know, here's how you do flank steak wrong. You know, oh, don't me. Okay, let's do it again. Good. I got another plate. You know, it'd be all right. Him or like Alton Brown, that'd be all right too.
Oh, Alton Brown. At least then he could tell you scientifically why this is working. It's like, that's fascinating. Tell me more as I eat.
You don't watch enough Food Network, do you, Baroness?
No cable. I don't.
Plug puller.
Yeah. If you can, if you have Netflix. I don't try to remember if you have Netflix.
Yeah,
or
we
not.
Have Netflix.
Watch like Good Eats.
No, I know who Alton Brown is.
Oh yeah, but watch Good Eats. You know me. I don't cook, but it was like, this is amazing. This is cool because He's talking scientific reasons why this happens for this food and it's why you cook it this way.
He did columns for Mental Floss for a long time too. So
oh, did he?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. Wait, what's Wartrap saying in the chat? Wow.
More shots fired.
I see.
They're just like
guys, Burrito King wearing like a really hat made from tinfoil wrapper. Of a burrito doesn't make you a king, apparently.
What I expect.
Yeah.
Very weak. Very, very weak.
So where I was
Donald
going.
Trump face.
Yeah, we went off track.
The other thing that I did, so for my birthday proper, aside from sleeping, we did go out for dinner because I do like myself some snow crab every once in a while.
Mm.
And the reason I can't remember most of what happened afterwards is because I also had the margarita, which was delicious. The strawberry margarita. I went with salt this time. It was delightful. But my question is, so that was actually a very good meal. What were the best meals you've had recently? I mean, Scott, you're a connoisseur of having, you know, actual good food. I made a grilled cheese sandwich one time. You're like, oh, what kind did you put in it? Oh, here's how you can kick that up a little bit. What have you had recently? It was really good.
Really nothing because I'm unemployed.
Ouch.
Yeah, that kind of makes a damper on like your social life and your,
just a tad,
your fun time. But I don't know. I'm a big fan of eating lots of random things too. I've got a friend of mine, Andre, who was on our show one time, who is a current U.S. military member who is deployed overseas. Mm-hmm. He and I always used to like try and find random shit that we would eat, and he always can one up me because he's had dog and camel and all kinds of like crazy ass shit when he's been deployed everywhere in the world. So I'm always trying to find like the random things that live in the sea that I can eat, especially to go to the West Coast because he wouldn't think to eat those things.
Have any gooey duck?
Yeah. Yeah, I have actually had that. There's a lot of like weird things you can eat that way, but I'm always a fan of like if you're gonna go to the expense of fucking making dinner, making at least fucking good. But a lot of people just like, oh, I made ground cheese and a piece of blood in it, and it was like best thing ever. You know, I'm like, that's really not what you should brag about on Twitter. You know, the things that Pork Chop eats, you know, you could brag about, but somebody else made it. Pork Chop didn't make it. So, if you ever follow Porkchop stream, every day I keep like harassing him to post like, what is he gonna eat for lunch? So we like to have this rivalry going here, because he actually does eat some really good stuff. I will say that he is lucky with what he has for like a Food Wagon Express where he's at.
And he also, you know, has made contacts with some of those like the smaller restaurants. Like they just know.
Mm-hmm.
He had mentioned once, I think last week, or maybe this week, where you predicted he was going to have fish.
Three to two odds.
And he showed up to the place, and they had some saved for him. Sure enough.
Three to two odds. These guys who get these odds in Vegas know their stuff. They have inside track knowledge that you and I are not privy to.
Yeah.
Even Porkchop didn't know he was going to eat fish that day, but he was.
They know the word on the street in Hawaii is, you know, here it's going to be 3-2 odds on that.
And he was mad at me for, like, jinxing it, but I'm like, dude, I can't make money on you when you're, like, a fucking sure bet the other way, or I can't make 3-2. I'm not making money on that either, you know?
So, Bio, what have you eaten lately that was really, really good?
Come on, you come up with fun recipes all the time.
Well, I mean, I'm thinking about spaghetti. That was kind of cool. It's been a while. I don't know, I haven't done that much major cooking because it's been kind of a rush. So yeah, I haven't done much.
God. Next. Come on, killer. Come up with something interesting that you've eaten here.
Well, I wouldn't say it was interesting, but I would say it was like a kind of a surprise. It was from the hunting trip because they provided a dinner, breakfast, lunch, and another dinner and breakfast, you know, on Sunday. So, Friday night, they actually provided steaks.
Ooh.
Pretty decently cooked steaks. I mean, I wouldn't say they're probably about average steaks. But they had this mashed potatoes that were literally just covered in, like, melted cheese. So good.
Okay.
And nice. The corn, it was like a cheesy, creamy corn. Like, really, really good. But I think it was the next night after dinner, they had a dessert that was basically cheesecake with sopapillas on top as the
was
breading.
What on top?
Sopapillas. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, so good.
Is that a box?
It's a box.
Pink contents.
I think this means her segment's failing. It's time to move to the next kid.
I think it is. Yeah. Let's move on.
Well, okay, I gave you guys an easy topic, and you're all like, yeah, no, but I haven't eaten anything interesting.
Yeah, but it was
interesting.
Like one that there's just no chance.
Make stuff up!
I had a unicorn steak burger.
Yeah, how did that turn out? I hear you have to really, like, tenderize them a bit.
Well, if you hit it too hard with the hammer, sparkles fly out.
Gotcha, yeah.
You don't want
it's kind of bitter
out.
Once all the sparkles are knocked out of it.
Although, I would say this, during the hunting trip, I did have to eat a small little piglet in front of its mother. Raw.
Wow.
Yeah.
That did you have to bite into its throat?
Yeah, pretty much.
Were you just trying to demoralize the sow so that you could, you know, so it would stay put for you while you shot it?
Much.
Okay.
Yeah. No, not so much, you know, shoot it. I was more likely just want to juggle with my bare hands, you know, half around. wrestle it down.
With the grapefruit knife that Bio was talking about earlier.
Yeah, with the grapefruit knife. Go to sleep. Yes. With the grapefruit spoon, not knife.
Did I say grapefruit knife, really?
You did say, did yeah. I went with it for a second, and I was like, wait, no. It's...
Yeah. Oh, what's our first question from the pink box?
Oh, no.
I put the same.
If you were to have an affair with five women while you're running for office.
Uh-oh. She can't even speak.
Wow. She hashtag literally can't even right now.
Come on.
Read it.
I don't want to know your answers to this question.
Pink box knows all.
Well, I saw the word penis, and I was immediately like, wait a minute.
That's when you're winning.
Nice junior high reaction to that one.
All right.
What's the funniest penis name you've ever heard? Mind you, we have taco rules for a reason.
I think the only one I can think of is the hammer from Dr. Horrible Sing-Along Blog.
That's a fairly recent thing, Killer.
I haven't heard anything else that was funnier.
Let's say I haven't. So the one I can think of is Reptar.
Oh, God.
You know, the knockoff Godzilla Reptar! From Rugrats.
Yeah.
From the Rugrats universe.
I've heard that, too.
Plundering the Asian cities.
What did...
Oh, I am Reptar.
Bubba Kayla says Sir Winkles.
Sir Winkles.
No, Wankles. Sir Wankles.
Wankles, sorry.
That's Wankles. That's great.
Got.
I don't even know.
Yeah, I'm... I had a...
Thick burrito.
That's horrible.
My sauce is terrible. Spicy.
Just terrible. You could do a lot with that.
You really could.
Wow, that works on a couple levels too there. Come on now.
Yep, it does. Yeah.
I don't know. Not many people share their penis names with me. I can't figure out why.
Because they know you'll repeat it.
Because they know it'll show up in a book later on, you know?
Pretty much, yeah.
Oh my God, did she do an entire book of nothing but... Oh!
Whoa!
Why are so many people telling her their penis names?
Why did she put in a children's book?
Oh, God.
Wow.
I guess the funniest one I always remember hearing was the Bloodhound Gang. In the great song, The Lap Dance is So Much Better When the Stripper Is Crying.
Oh, yeah.
And he says in the lyric in there how hard it is to polish the one-eyed weasel when you're doing 65 in an 18-wheeler holding a gallon of milk in one hand. I never knew missing exploited children could be so sexy. I mean, that line right there all together just did it for me.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
It's even better because he's like a transvestite because he talks about how hard it is to hide his hard-on when he's dressed like Minnie Pearl. It's golden genius. If you've never listened to Bloodhound Gang, you should listen to that one.
That was.
So we have some others from the chat. Porkchop says Womb Raider. Bubba Caleb saying Caleb's Bubba.
Caleb's... really?
That's what he says.
We didn't. Okay, the question wasn't what's your penis name. The question is what's the funniest name that you've heard.
You said that people have not revealed that to you, and now they are. You got what you asked for.
I did not ask for that. I just made the statement that I can't really tell funny names if I don't hear names to be.
I kind of
set myself up for that. You're right.
Yeah, you kind of did.
Penis on the brain.
Yeah. Moving on.
If you could start your life over, what would you do differently? Well, I would start by changing that question from the last one.
That's it.
Or at least changing how I phrased. I can't really answer that question because phrasing was definitely in play there. Yep. Yes.
I'm not gonna lie. These questions are always kind of dumb to me. I'm just
thank
like,
you! That's what I keep saying! Let's not go from the pink box!
Hold on. No, the ones like this particular one. Mm. Not the ones about talking about your willy. I'm talking about the whole
thing. Name if you
could redo
willies.
It, if you could redo your life, what would you do? It's like, I'm not... I don't care. I mean, I am
they're
where I
girls'
am
night out questions, Bio.
Everything that's happened.
This is actually what girls talk about on their nights
ownership.
Out.
extreme, then I need to bust into the middle of these girls' night out things and just be like, extreme ownership.
Hey.
Get at it. And then just.
Kyle, that is not okay. That is not okay.
I need the Jocko Willink shirt that has his face. It just says good back.
I gotta want that shirt. I gotta do. I saw
yeah. Yeah, that's God's that's
like, what
shirt.
The hell are they fucking talking about?
Yeah.
Jocko is he's a retired Navy SEAL who went through Iraq and everything, and him and another retired Navy SEAL wrote a book about leadership. It's called
It's actually a very good book.
Yeah. It is
yeah, they actually go around the country now basically getting contracted by businesses to
teach leadership.
You know, own it. Here's what you got to do. And yeah. So he started a podcast after he showed up on the Tim Ferriss podcast and then Joe Rogan podcast where he kind of talked about Iraq and his experience there. And So I'm a fan of his podcast.
I am too.
Yeah.
Very much so.
And Killer's read the book. I haven't yet. I need to.
I read the first part of it. I have to.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm trying Jeff, to find
like,
out.
I don't care.
So yeah, when I hear these questions, I'm just like extreme ownership.
Oh shit!
Did we just lose
them? No.
We did lose them. Oh no!
Scott, can you hear us?
He's nope. Just like
we did.
He
did we lose him in TeamSpeak too?
He's not responding. Nope, he's gone.
Yeah, he's gone. He noped out. We noped out our guest by talking about Jocko Willink.
He's intense, I have to admit.
Yes.
He can't be intense. Oh, he does a great reading of like the Henry V, We Banner Brothers. That was really good.
Matt, is that from the new episode? That
yeah, the latest episode 15.
I could imagine. So he's one of the few people who chose an English major who I would not prod at. For choosing an English major. One,
well,
I think he chose it for good reasons.
Yeah, he
explains
his reasons.
Because he chose it for a good reason, yeah. Because he really flipped it around, like, you know, he already had his training.
Yeah.
In terms of shooting tactics, all that stuff. That part's down pat.
Yeah.
But then he said, I need, you know, as an officer, I need to learn to communicate.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I can understand that. I can dig that.
Totally get that.
It's not like he needed to go into a STEM field.
No, he didn't.
Or something. That would not have advanced his career at all. But being a good infantry officer, another story.
Or special forces.
Yeah. Right. But since he was dealing with on-the-ground scenarios, you know, it's critical to explain things.
Exactly. Right orders,
Reports. Oh, more shots fired.
Uh-oh.
Hmm?
Yeah, poor Chip saying, just like Scott to disconnect. Walking Dead commercial probably came on. It's messed up.
Scott, you with us?
I make one comment and I get fucking shit canned off the show. That's it. Now I'm even blacklisted.
We didn't even hear that comment. You were just like looking at the camera, so we figured you just noped out once we start talking about Jocko Willink.
Now somebody snipered me. I wonder which one of you it was with the pink box.
This is JockoPodcast.com, I'm just saying. Check it out.
Well, hold on a second. I can try and get you back on.
Kill me again in front of all your loyal minions.
No, I only take out the two regular.
Listen, we've determined that it's not Baroness's fault. Because I found an article this week that explains...
You know what, Bio? That's actually why I'm wearing the cat ears today, as a matter of fact.
So there's a study that's saying that there's a certain type of parasite that exists within cats that is transmittable to humans, and it has been known in their study to cause fits of rage and such, outbursts.
That explains Baroness so well.
She's not responding. We're going to have like some more technical difficulties in a second, I think.
Yeah.
Where Killer might get inadvertently.
So this one I'm looking at is newscientist.com says explosive road rage like anger linked to parasites spread by cats. Just saying it's not her fault. It's
science, people, science.
Yeah, you have to be like Reddit because science. The debate is over because science.
Exactly. I hate that.
It's like whenever somebody on science has never been wrong,
I'll never
learn more things.
Like whenever somebody on Reddit like starts like linking or like invoking the Bill Nye the Climate Guy for some reason. Like it fucking means like he's a fucking comedian who couldn't make it, who won a kid's TV show, right? You're real about this, people.
Well, and my, so going on that subject, my thing about it is that, you know, okay, so there's, if there's data pointing to that, then there's data pointing to that. But the problem is when we start talking about natural systems as large as they're talking about with this, I mean, we've screwed up just with breeding wolves and such, where, you know, we were trying to, it was up in the Midwest, I think it's around Yellowstone, where they're reintroducing gray wolves.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember because that was actually a project I was assigned to freshman year in biology, where it's, you know, pitching about why this is important. Now they've like taken over and they're just tearing up all sorts of stuff, and they're going to have to go, you know, do a hunt on them again, restore that. It's just like when we start screwing with natural systems, we realize, you know, just how powerless we kind of are with some of this stuff, even though there's the argument, you know, yeah, because science. Yeah, we solved this problem because science. Did we really? No. And I think, did Scott?
I'm still here. I'm still here. Skype has decided now that it needs to update itself. So
that is always a disaster with
Skype.
I
hate Skype. I really do hate Skype for that
reason. I'm honestly still on an old version. I'm on 6.21.0.104 from my 2014 just because I hated the new layout so much.
I just never auto-update anything until I've got nothing to...
I pretty much have to like throw some dummy files in so it would just not even look anymore for an update. It's just, they started trying to make it look like text messages on an iPhone. I'm like, this is a business application. That's what, you know, Skype was made for. And
well, it's made for terrorists, let's be honest.
Wow.
That's we have to get the NSA to have the back doors. That's
exactly
it.
Never
be abused.
That is the fucking crux of the argument about why the PlayStation Network has to be open and unencryptable, right? Because the fucking terrorists will win, right? I mean, the same thing with the shit.
Yeah.
And you can't tell me that the Microsoft overlords are not bowing to the FBI's wishes to do this to put backdoors in here. Or, you know, I don't know. I'm very cynical when it comes to shit.
We actually had an interesting issue with that. When I was working in healthcare, we had that issue because of some HP servers, because there was a released glitch. Well, not a glitch. It was something they put in on purpose where they basically set a easily known password that, you know, everybody in HP knew as kind of their remote.
It's guessed.
Yeah, pretty much.
Or password one.
Pretty much, yeah. But they had that in for remote
purposes.
It
might be
true,
but you're not supposed to say it.
But yeah, so that was a big deal, and it actually resulted in us ditching that model of HP server. Like, it was a huge deal for us. Like, whoa, no. Nope, sorry.
Fuck this shit.
Pretty much, yeah. So, I mean, I think they forgot what model they got, but we only had a handful of those anyway. It was to a point where, okay, if the public knows this, no, we cannot risk this.
Even the public doesn't know that, you really can't risk that.
No,
you got HIPAA
compliance,
but you can't have
that. But it was just really funny. The way some of those things pop up. I think there was that may have even been a SAN, now that I think of it. Unfortunately, we already had plans to discontinue that SAN and bring in one by another company. So, that was kind of interesting.
Yep.
So yeah, they definitely put back doors, even if it's just for them, let alone someone else.
Look at that. I got 7,096.
I'm working
Rival
on my
box.
Comeback, by the way. I don't know if you guys saw this.
I saw that you were kicking ass in your bets and made a bit of a comeback.
So Baroness has
I'm
more money than I do.
I have more hours than you do, too.
So that proves there is no gender gap.
Yes, because Ankhbot totally has a field in there that says, you know, male and female.
Hey,
different,
there he is.
I'm allowed back
in.
What?
All right.
Thanks,
pork chop. That's why
world. We don't have nice things.
No,
pork
right.
Chop. In Obama.
It's a click.
Yeah, pork chop.
It's a click.
Is it a click?
There
I
we go.
It's a click.
It's funny, though. So the story with points is I was the first person to breach 20,000 20,000 rival bucks, which can get you nothing. A whole lot of nothing.
Yeah,
Bitcoin.
For now.
Yeah, it's Bitcoin.
it's because Bitcoin would not bet anything in the heist.
Well,
he would bet
smart.
Like six points.
Smart.
It's like, you have 17,000 points and you're betting six.
I only bet the tenths on it. So if I have, right now I have 1,740 rival bucks, I'm only going to dump 40.
No, see,
that's it.
I get you.
But then people were like, no, throw it all in, this bullcrap. So I did.
They're just
and
jelly.
I won,
that's all it
and
is.
I won.
They're just jelly.
Did it again, won again. Did it a third time because Baroness was all, I want to see it now.
No, because
that's
the
right.
second
right.
time you
all.
Did it, you waited until like the one time I was not tabbed over and then just went for it.
That was amazing, though.
Because you were like, Baroness, are you here? Because I went back and looked at chat layers. Like, Baroness, are you here? Well, I guess you're missing it. I was like, no, that is not, no, stop that.
You could have just scrolled up. Honestly, you could have scrolled up.
I did, but it wasn't, it's not the same as witnessing it live.
Well, yeah. But it's kind of funny because people were all collusion for the longest time on that. Over some points, on points from a bot. They're just like, oh, you're just giving yourself points. Like, look, I have the exact same percentage chance as somebody who's, you know, marked as a regular here at RCM, which is, you know.
You got to remember, the human brain doesn't do well with statistics.
It's true. Don't do well with facts either when it comes to facts versus feels. I'm just saying.
It's all about the feels, man.
It's all about those feels.
I mean, look at Baroness. She feels like a cat, and therefore she wears cat ears.
she identifies as a cat. I love that song.
No.
Don't even kill her.
No.
Don't
no.
even.
I read something that was like, you got it. Wow. This Uh-oh. Is a new low. Some artist has actually married a rock. Yes.
Bez not Kanye.
Yeah. Yeah. Some female artist married a rock.
Okay, well, that makes a little bit more sense to me now.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
How so?
Yeah.
Why does it make more sense to you?
Because she's shunning the, it has to do with the patriarchy killer.
It doesn't.
It does.
I read up on it. No, it didn't.
It does. It does because it's crazy. That's why.
I'll go with that part of it, but.
What was her official reason?
I.
Come on, you just said you read up on it.
I skimmed the article and. Because it.
Skimmed.
The stupidity of it was just so massive. If I looked at it directly, I would become more stupid from reading it.
Where's Don at? I'll let him read it.
I had to watch. Okay.
You know, Killer, that is not okay.
No, I completely understand
this,
Killer.
Something.
Because I had to get my oil changed in my car today because we're going on a trip tomorrow morning. And usually I just drop it off and, you know, I go do things and then I come back and, you know, Ethan just has everything like fixed and it's amazing and, you know, it's shiny and beautiful. But it was cold today and I had to have the car back. So he's like, oh, come in, I'll do it. You know, you can wait in the lobby and whatever. And so I don't have cable. And I don't watch TV very often because I'm busy, you know.
Oh, God.
I'm at work. I'm at, you know, whatever.
Oh, there he goes.
He's here.
No, he's here. Yeah.
He didn't move for a second. He didn't move.
We got worried. But yeah,
well,
so they had TV on. And I, like, this, I'm trying to think of what the name of the show was. I think it was one of the Fox shows, but it's.
It wasn't Dinosaur Train.
No, it wasn't Dinosaur Train. It was the Zooey Deschanel is in it. That comedy. I felt my brain cells dying as I watched this thing. I'm like, how did they do? And then it dawned on me that there are actually people that get paid to write this script, and that made me hurt a little bit inside.
Yeah.
Is this called New Girl?
Yes. Okay. That. Yes.
Oh my
that.
God.
I'm looking up now. It's.
I had.
Rotten
I had
Rotten
to watch that.
93%. So you appear to be in the minority.
I am usually in the minority when it comes to popular television.
Oh God.
If that's an example of something that's one of the better shows on TV nowadays, I'm so glad that I don't watch. I'm glad. Just.
You know, one of those bad shows actually I like is called Undateable Live.
Oh, God.
Really? It's a guilty pleasure. It's another NBC thing. Started out as like a really shitty sitcom that didn't go anywhere, right? Then they just decided, oh, fuck it, we'll just do it live. Seriously, just do it live. So they screw up and they miss lines and things, and it's like a half hour. It's not like the live taped and shown later like SNL. Mm-hmm. Actually, it's kind of funny. It's worthwhile. They're pretty strong comedians on that. It's worth a watch when it comes back on. But no, now that Megan Fox has been back on that show, I've watched it. You bet. It worked. That was the whole point. We can't get Zooey Deschanel to be on because she's having babies and such, so we'll put Megan Fox on there.
Okay, apparently Zach Braff is a guest on there. Of course, Donald Faison's going to be on there. Zach Braff.
They bring a musical guest on every week, too, to play, like, you know, a 30-second intro. You know, it's kind of funny. Sure. But it's a funny show. Some of the bits they try and get into to do live are funny.
Because we are awesome.
The internet's trying to kill all of you. It happens.
One day Skynet would arise.
It's like we got Scott back, and then all of a sudden it's but has it been on Twitter?
That's why it probably decided humanity had to go.
It was pork chop.
Has it been on Twitter, and is its name Tay?
Ooh, that's a funny story. That does make me laugh.
Yeah, it's messed up.
Are we talking about the Microsoft AI?
Yeah, the Microsoft AI. I read about that. Immediately went anti-Semitic. Went full genocidal.
Like, you gotta be kidding me.
You didn't see this story?
Heard of
no.
This?
Oh, it was bad.
I don't know what Microsoft was thinking. So basically they tied a bot into a Twitter account called Tay something or other. I forgot the full Twitter name. And the whole point was it's going to interact with the kids. And it's going to learn from them. It's going to hang out with the kids. And I tweet all the time, blah, blah, blah. And of course, 4chan finds it, among other places, and they know they're going to have fun with this thing. And in no time, they have it like saying, "Make America Great Again," calling Ted Cruz the Zodiac Killer, saying stuff.
Oh, I was wondering the Zodiac Killer Ted Cruz thing came from. Okay.
Same things involving former German chancellors.
I'm talking about our current president with a very racist term.
And the funny thing is, and we say that AI is just a good idea. Like, we should keep advancing AI. It's like, no, if it's that easy to influence it.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, the biggest criticism of not doing AI is basically it's going to learn, then it's going to decide just to kill us.
Pretty much.
The more practical is, we'll just make a worse version of ourselves. And no one wants to deal with that asshole.
That's true.
Definitely, it denies the Holocaust twice, which is really funny. Like, they just have to confirm it.
As it implements the plans, it just says "kek."
Yeah, it's fantastical fail. Fantastical fail.
It's hilarious to me because everybody takes those things seriously, so they're just like, "Oh no, all these racist people." It's like you do realize they just do this stuff because they know it bothers you. It's like I guarantee in real life, not like that at all. But when they know that there are people out there that just get so offended by everything, that just feeds them. They're just like, yes, it's
good,
time.
Good, let your hate flow.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah. Oh, she's looking at the pink box again. Watch out.
No, I was checking because I keep getting these warning messages that my internet connection isn't fast enough for the Skype call, which is amazing because it's like...
Now, question. Baron's,
you know,
home,
is.
Right?
Yeah, yeah. Baron's probably downloading something.
Just yell at him like, "Baron, stop downloading porn."
Yeah.
That was about to say. Bad Baron. Bad.
No, Baron's in chat right now, too.
Come on. I mean, she even wears cat ears for you. Or dresses up like Godzilla.
Yeah, he is in chat. Yeah, the mic was hilarious.
I had to bring that up. Was that out supposed to?
But that's... Once again, with the bot thing, that's why it's so funny to me, though, is that these people knew, I mean, these types of bots learn certain ways, and people have mastered that, so they're just like, eh.
But again, this is how Skynet starts.
Yeah. Right, yeah. And it's going to be somebody in 4chan.
It's a Holocaust-denying
like,
robot system.
Mm-hmm. LOL, delete humanity. And it's just going to be like, I stand behind that. But yeah, so it ended, the story ended with... I think that by the end of the day, they pretty much pulled the plug. It was just like, see, the last tweet. So they purged everything. They're probably like sanitizing. Yeah. It's like when that one AI, I think when Watson discovered UrbanDictionary.com.
Oh, God.
And they were just like, oh, no, bail out, bail So they're like, you know, computer scientists right now that are still purging core memory or something on this AI that's just going off about all the different possible horrible things that could be said.
But my favorite part about this is they chose Twitter. You know, any app you could use this on, Twitter, which has a direct fire hose to, like, the Library of Congress. Like, every tweet, everything is always recorded. You can't unscrub some of this shit, Microsoft.
Right.
Your stain on your mattress is going to be there for eternity.
For 4chan, the people on 4chan and other sites were archiving these things as they came in. Like, I wouldn't doubt it if there are YouTube live streams that were going on where people just had it up and they were just laughing and recording everything. Just
TechCrunch has screenshots of a lot of it too, so you can read the story there.
But it's just one of those things where it's like, really, that's the platform you're going to choose. You couldn't do this as an actual lab where you bring in people and interact with them. No, we're going to put it on Twitter because that's just a brilliant idea.
Oh yeah, well, it's,
you know,
it's
PR.
It's PR. Yeah, it's PR completely. Because all the kids are using Twitter nowadays.
Right. Which is funny because I think I had read actually that kids are not using, like, they use more like Instagram, Snapchat,
Instagram,
stuff like that.
Facebook is actually becoming very popular again with them.
Sure.
Really? There are a whole bunch of face baggers out there I don't know about.
Apparently.
It's funny because I forgot I think it was the Ace of Spades guy, blogger.
Was it?
Yeah, who had said that he was leaving Twitter.
Yeah.
But he didn't go for the obvious reason that some other kind of conservative people were going with. He went with the idea that he recognized that he was creating free content for Twitter to basically sell. It's that whole idea that if a service is free, more than likely you're
the customer. Yeah, you're the product.
You always are. Somebody is.
Right. Because, you know, otherwise why would a business be up? Unless there's some money to make it sustainable.
Although, last time I checked, there's Twitter still and it hasn't made any money.
No, but Ev looks like he's doing okay, though. Right? If you see any pictures, it looks like he's doing all right. There's some money coming somewhere.
Sure. Somewhere.
But that's kind of the thing is there. And there's
he's not eating grilled cheese with a beagle on his lap like I am, right?
right. Making his own spaghetti at home. But it's kind of funny that some of these will, and the excuse they ultimately make when they do fail, it's always been kind of funny for some of those businesses. There's a certain person doing it's not Kickstarter, it's some other website, who has previously been rather successful at fundraising and not necessarily delivering what they promised.
Yeah.
They have another one up.
Yeah.
They do a whole new series, and I think 15 days away, something like that from it, and they're just like at 31% of their goal. Because people kind of wake up.
They wake up
and go, you're not delivering on this. Why do I keep giving you money?
Because you're stupid.
Because, you know, doing that and then going around the country, you know, doing seminars and stuff or conferences, getting paid like 20 grand or something. I don't know the exact number. And it's just like, whoa, so you're getting money from that, but you're telling me that I need to give you money to, you know, do post-production for some video you've already filmed.
Getting that paper, son.
Yeah, exactly.
Hold on. Speaking of failed internet projects.
Porkchop.
Porkchop says, Scott. oh, that was amazing timing, sir.
Nice.
Because it was about Porkchop. I was like, Porkchop says, Scott and I can be reached on our MySpace pages. That's how we keep in touch with the internet. That was well done, Scott. Well done. I'll give you that.
Yeah,
one.
Oh God, MySpace is things. Still around, isn't it? Who owns MySpace?
I'm curious now. It's been at least 9 years since I've been on my MySpace page. I wonder if it's still there.
It is.
Probably. It is. If you haven't deleted it, I'm sure it's there.
I think it's some type of musical service of some kind,
oriented. And that was one of the things I always knew people for, is if they were starting up a band or it's kind of like their fan page idea. It was purchased by Time this year because it was acquired by News Corporation in 2005.
Right.
$580 million.
Yeah, I think he sold it for like way under that though.
They currently, let's see. I wouldn't doubt it. It's just been announced on February 11th, 2016. It was announced that MySpace and its parent company have been bought out by Time Inc. So there's no number disclosed.
I think it was disclosed somewhere, but
it's heavily undersold though.
It was
kind of like what's going to be happening to some of the Yahoo stuff coming up. I think, which is funny because they bought Tumblr, and really? Thought they were they own Tumblr and they thought that they were going to do some
make
stuff
money.
With it, and it's just bleeding profit from what I've read. Investors are furious.
Yeah, it's like almost like companies of today just don't understand the ideas that could, you know, make them profits of tomorrow, and they want someone to make who wants
and
to save them.
Is no more.
They want to see what Kay will tweet in 24 hours if exposed to the internet.
I feel almost like I should recreate it. Although,
oh, this is,
God, no.
It would be,
this is a
it
weird
would be
time
so
warp.
Hard to recapture the magic of 2002.
Are we going to do the song now, Time Warp? No?
Let's do...
You and Killer can
elbow
do
sex,
the Time Warp
elbow sex.
Elbow sex. Come on, you know you liked the movie. It was great.
It grows on you.
It
you have to
grow.
See it live. If you go through
that
live performance
true.
Of it, you'll enjoy it a lot more.
Especially when the audience starts participating, you know, with their...
And you're auctioned as a virgin, yes. I'm looking, it's really kind of creepy because I'm looking through my MySpace page now and I'm seeing a lot of people on here with like maiden names.
Mm-hmm.
But I probably
yeah,
wouldn't,
yeah,
you know, like, well, who's that? Oh, yeah, that's who that is now, you know?
Mm.
But as I look through it, there's a couple of them that have been updated. So somebody
interesting.
Four or five of these people have been doing some work on MySpace.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
interesting.
You know what that means, right? You have to break
the
your
bots
relationship.
Strong.
Yeah, the bots are
yeah,
strong.
The bots.
They're evolving.
Listen, there's some
they're
bills.
Becoming real people.
There's some bills in Nigeria that have your name on them.
But it's funny. I mean, I'm seeing some of my friends who are like pre-kids, which is kind of funny.
Holy crap.
Yeah. Like, how young these people are. Like, I'm still my same old fat self. Like, I'm like that picture could have been taken last weekend. You know what I mean? Thanks for ruining that for me.
Yep.
No.
You're welcome. You're
welcome. You know,
welcome.
That's another thing that we can blame on Microsoft's Tay Tweets AI.
Mm-hmm.
Taking us down that dark path of social media.
Taking a dark path of multimedia. Was Baron going to be streaming tonight on the Twitch?
Yeah,
channel?
Is Baron going to be?
He will be on tonight. He won't be on for an all-night stream. He did that
right.
last night.
Right.
Because we have to be up in the morning,
which
so
was hilarious.
Drive to Pennsylvania.
I'm
but
sorry.
He will be on at 11 for his Let's Play, and if he's still in chat, he can post in chat what it is he's playing tonight. Because I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm still trying to figure out what my old MySpace.
Yeah, when he's playing Dying Light, that was pretty humorous with KPN,
was,
his coworker.
Oh yeah.
Nothing's coming up. And I'm very sad about this.
My name's unique enough, it comes up pretty...
Well, I know what name I used at that time frame, and it's not one that I use now, so I've just tried it with different variations, and nothing's coming up, so it must be gone forever.
Forever?
Let's make MySpace great again.
I know, right?
We need that hat. Porkchop, we're going
to
wear that hat
to
at RivalCon.
Keep,
make MySpace great again. We're going to get hats for that.
I can make you hats
okay.
for that.
Okay, Baron said we're playing at the Mountains of Madness, and if it blows, we'll go to Dying Light. Yeah, he played another game, Sophie's Curse, before that.
Oh, was
that? It was kind of interesting. It was one of those jump scare games, though, where it's a jump scare ending, and those kind of get old to me quick. Like, that's all you got is an overly loud sound in a face.
It's like overly sweet candy that's really good at that moment. But
yeah, it's kind of like when you get old and you're trying, like, cake with buttercream icing. You're just like...
There's nothing wrong with buttercream icing, Bio. We've been through
this. I disagree.
You can disagree
entirely.
All you want and be wrong, but, you know, whatever. I eat that stuff by the tub. I wish that were a lie. But anyway.
Now I'm expecting her to come in next time with the Wilford Brimley mustache and just be like, diabetes.
Don't pick on my betis.
Diabetes.
Ugh, alright. Bio, did you want to... You had
yeah, we could do a few.
You had a scavenger hunt. Now, remember, when we have a winner... to give the next question before you take the pause to give
yeah,
the winner.
Yeah. Somebody's critical. Surprise.
Hey,
surprise.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah,
hey,
I'm
no,
sorry,
Harrison.
It shouldn't...
No.
Wait, now, Baroness, I'm going to own this, but I'm going to say you really need to figure out how to control that cat parasite within you that is fueling this rage.
Oh, I have a way of controlling it.
Don't you need to use, like, fresh step litter box stuff, or what?
I was also told, interestingly enough, by you, that I hold too much of my emotions in. So all I'm doing is letting some of that release so that I feel more relaxed. I'm only doing what you, as my friend, asked me to do.
I'll own that. Definitely. So, Scott, I don't think you've been here when we've done a scavenger hunt. So what we're going to do is I just find riddles off the internet and tell people to find an image that somehow fits it. It doesn't have to fit it in the most obvious ways.
I know, right?
And you guys can come up with some too. I think we'll just do three or four tonight.
He's letting the internet do this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The first time we got cow pictures. Yeah.
If you get it and we agree that we like it, I believe it was 1,000 rival bucks.
Indeed.
That we give people. So
I mean,
yes.
It's a substantial amount. So put some thought into this, peeps.
Yeah. Be sure to bring your A game. No tryhards. Just do it. Get at it. Okay, so I'll grab the very first one here, the first riddle. And that will be... you can see it, but it is also clear.
See it?
You can see it, but it is also clear. So now we just need to wait on them to drop an image.
My bank account, that's what it's going to be.
So
in the next couple of days, it's
going to
be my bank account.
Write, like, 000, and then write killer's bank account, and there you go.
Pretty much.
Now, Malorium, you don't say it. You have to find a picture. And say, come on, guys. You know, you remember how to play this. Don't pull this crap. I will start banning people. I will swing
you're
that hammer.
You're going to start banning people for talking about answers in chat.
Find me an image. Go to Google.
How dare you talk in chat, chat? Shame on you.
You put something in, and just for that, anybody that sends a picture of water, nope, you don't win.
Not a peep, or else Bio's going to ban you from chat.
There we go. There's Bam. He sends a picture of a glass.
That's the point, though, Malorian, that there's not one answer. It's the answer that we find the funniest or that we like. That's why they're kind of open-ended.
Oh, he's going back to work.
You do that.
All right, we'll catch you later, sir.
All right, Sam has one. Okay.
That's actually a really cool bridge. Got it for you.
Well, actually, I was looking at the bridge part itself
first. Oh, that would freak me out. Have you ever been on those walkways that are like, you know, two or three stories up, but they have the glass bottom and you have to walk across? And just like... Even though you know you're perfectly fine, you're just like, this is creepy.
Okay, so we have this bridge.
Scott, really?
Workshop has one here. Bubba, explain to me in bullet form how to post links in chat bio. Now, Sam, you only get one entry, so you got to tell me which one is your one. You guys are kind of acting like you've never done this before. I'm a little disappointed. A little bit disappointed.
You are a disappointment.
I may have to give myself 1,000 rival bucks every time one of you people fail. I'm not going to do that. But I like to
Malorium does one.
There we go, Malorium.
Doesn't work, though.
Well, no, if you copy the whole thing, it's sometimes Twitch chat breaks stuff. It's weird.
Damn you, Twitch.
I love how Pookchop's link says, eyedropper, it's okay, Scott.
Yeah, if you
Scott
read
sucks,
it.
But it's okay.
Sorry, Scott, I'm going to have to go with Pookchop on that one.
I kind of like that one. I kind of like Malorium's.
Yeah, Malorium's pretty good. But
it would freak me out.
It's not just water. It's not just water. It's like, you know,
glass,
a clear pool. Okay, so Sam is sticking with his first one, the glass walkway.
At least four stories up. I mean, that would be freaking me out.
Hey, those are both good contenders.
Not a height person, Baroness?
I'm actually not bad with height. It's just the idea that there's nothing underneath you that you can see. And even though you know it's there, it's like the fact that you can't see anything underneath you is just kind of weird.
It's a paradox.
Okay, so it looks like we have two people. So go ahead and decide.
We got three.
What's
Valorium, so Sam, and Pork Chop.
Okay,
yeah,
so Pork
Chop wasn't really answering the question that so
does.
Much as, like...
No.
What, a window that says Scott sucks.
Explain, killer.
I was actually just looking at, like, the you from so 3 seconds ago. I was yelling at the you on my... at the past you.
Alright. Let's go.
Take
those three.
So, everybody pitch. Which one do you like?
I'm gonna go with Pork Chop. Just because I can.
And he throws in chat, I thought it was very clear, and everyone can see that the Scott sucks, but it is okay. That's terrible!
It was very clear. So it was clear.
Yeah.
That's why.
Guess I'll vote for Pork Chop.
Okay, so we got two for Pork Chop.
I was gonna go with Malorium's one, because I thought that was rather nicely done.
Bio.
I mean, it's all sorts of clear things and scary things.
I'm stuck between Malorium and Sam on this one, because I do like the general idea, the way you kind of answered it.
I pick one.
And Bubba says I can't post
I'll go
anything.
I'll go with Sam, just because I like the bridge.
So that means Scott wins. I mean...
Pork Chop wins.
Pork Chop wins because you're going with that. Okie doke.
Yeah.
Let me give Le Pork Chop points, but let's go ahead and do this other one first.
Bubba says he can't post anything because Bio has decided not to explain things.
Wow.
I have many times. Many times. Yeah, Pork Chop, you are true. The message is clear.
Come on.
I love when he reads these questions
I'm looking through these to find one. Some of them, I actually go, ooh, can't do that, because Baroness will yell at me later.
Oh, please, really?
You don't hurry up. I'm going to make a riddle of my own.
What is put on the table, cut, but never eaten? Dropping it in chat now. And then I'm going to go give Pork Chop his points.
What is put on the table, cut, but never eaten?
Never eaten. I feel like I should know this answer to this riddle.
I remember the key is, you know, it's whatever's. Whatever kind of answers it, but it's funny.
I was going this. Well, no, I don't, because with my luck, that'll be the one clip that my brother decides to show my grandmother.
Oh God!
Well, in that case, Baroness, you have to come up with the next riddle.
I have to come up with the next riddle because I can't answer.
No, just because.
All right, Pork Chop, I got one.
That would be the clip. That you see.
The fact that this comes from allworship.com kind of frightens me.
Yeah, commercial free Christian music. Okay, with a deck of cards. So it is a deck of cards here.
And Sam posts a picture. Alright.
Okay.
Give it another 30 seconds, maybe?
Yeah. Okay.
All
See, I'm seeing where Sam's
is...
going
oh,
here. I'm
go.
Digging that. That works. Well. Wow.
I already know my pick. Even though technically
I think I know mine as well.
Yeah, you know what it is. Don't lie. Malorium. Good job. Good job. So, did everyone look at the pictures?
No.
You know, Sam, you call it a weakness. I call it a strength. I'm just calling it because I know what I like.
Yeah, because you're focusing on it. You're trying to fix your weaknesses.
Focusing on it, yeah.
Yeah. See how it is.
Although, the allegations that were placed on me early in the week.
Again, you're the one who started those rumors. You can't start rumors about yourself and then
they went to a deny them. To get this published.
Wait, killer?
That's what I was about to say. It's like, when did I do this?
Wow. Okay, so let's go ahead and call it. Which one? We have a deck of cards from allworship.com.
Yeah, which is now trying to recruit me to... I'm not quite sure what religion they... They keep wanting me to sign up.
Okay, fairness, going to a Bible study, apparently.
No.
We have flowers.
The flowers are pretty. Flowers,
and an image of a two of hearts with a lovely...
Asian
girl plastered on it.
Chat, Sam is asking if, okay, so this is a question for bio. Save the Asian girl or save the world bio? Which will you choose?
That's kind of easy. Save the world.
Bullshit!
You say you save the Asian girl and then there's no planet to live on.
Or you save the world and there's whole nations full of Asian girls left.
That's
is
very
where
true.
I
as well.
Was going, but yeah.
Very true.
All right.
See, Porkchop.
So far, we have two votes for Malorian.
Porkchop knew.
All right. Fair enough.
I wasn't really. Yeah.
You think this one was kind of a weak one, round?
Yeah.
Eh.
Well, it's okay because you're gonna get to come up with the next riddle.
I'd go with. I'm not coming up with the next riddle, so.
Well, it's almost time for Baron anyway, so we're gonna have the problem.
Yeah, it's almost time for Baron.
Yeah, you can't drop that on me like that. No.
Yeah, we could.
Oh, I totally can.
You don't try. You will fail miserably.
You me.
By the RCM legal department? Yes, we do. Because I remember I drew the
torch
draw.
You did.
I knew that was
gonna
come back to
you?
Bite us.
So, Scott, what are you picking?
I don't know.
You know the right answer. Search your feelings.
He's gonna go with the flowers.
Yeah, I'll go flowers. Because this way there can't be a split decision with four people.
Baroness.
No, I was going with the flowers.
So now it's a split decision.
Which is why he said it, because he was the only one of the three of
you
who was paying attention.
That means
they get 500 points each.
We could do that, yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that.
We can do that.
We'll do that.
Okay, so do we want to do one last one, then we'll wrap up?
Indeed.
Alright.
Okay. Murder. Not gonna do that one.
Oh, come on, you know you want to.
No, I'm not gonna do that one.
Yes, you do.
As dangerous as this is, I am kind of curious as to the riddles that you decide. No.
I've dropped a few in chat before, in our TeamSpeak chat.
Yeah, well, that's true.
Have a good one ready, people.
I'm not
when
questioning
your decision.
When you
put a knife in me, you will cry, not I. What am I?
What?
Dropped it in chat. Okay, so just to clarify, I'm giving Sam and Malorium 500 each.
Yep.
Okay.
Read the riddle one more time.
Sure, hold on here. When you put a knife in me, you will cry, not I. What am I?
We know that.
What is the number? Let's see if I can find Sam here in the list.
Your own leg.
Wow.
Damn it, now I'm thinking of young
you
Frankenstein.
Have split personalities because apparently
no, because the leg is talking to you when you put a knife
exactly.
in me.
Blast
you cry.
No one?
No one.
I hate you guys so
apparently
much.
Why are they putting, oh god, beautiful uh-oh Asian girl wallpaper?
All right. It has to answer the riddle too, so.
Well.
Pandering only gets you so far. You have to get through that first hurdle.
Well, think about this. If Bio were to stick a knife into this, he would cry. He would. So technically, it does answer the riddle.
Wow. Killer on the defense. Okay, let's see here.
I like that. Wow. I gotta go with Malorium on that one.
Yeah, apparently the pandering is Mr. McCoy now.
No. I like that one. That was pretty good for Malorium.
Now,
why is she doing
what do you
that
mean
in her
that
dining room? Oh, wait, because it's 4-H. Okay, never mind. That makes sense to me.
It's messed up.
I didn't read the t-shirt first. I was a little...
Would you really cry that much, Scott? Would you really cry that much? I didn't think you would.
Yeah, Scott has been putting them in the chat here for his own answers.
Yep.
And they've been pretty funny.
I don't want to like compete with people. I'll give them real points.
Yeah. Real points.
Let's say you'd have to have a Twitch account to receive those real points anyway, so.
Yeah. All right.
But for the record, I used a picture of Pork Chop.
Of course.
Yes.
Would you really cry if you stuck a knife in him?
Tears of joy. You can't have, what is it? You can't have a little slaughter without some laughter. Right?
I'm thinking there may be a protective order at RivalCon.
No, he'll be sitting on my lap as he always does.
Wow.
Then so was that?
The sad thing is that was before you even said that. That was the thought that was in my head. Was that yeah?
With us wearing our matching Make MySpace Great Again hats.
Exactly. Exactly. I will make those for you.
Actually, we will wear them. Just because I know Dan, if he shows up, will wear his MAGA hat, we'll have to wear that.
So, all right. We got Porkchop, Malorium, and Sam yet again. So,
yep.
I'm going to go with Malorium.
Okay, you're going to go with Malorium with Piglet.
Porkchop is saying tears are tears. I'll take them.
I'm honestly going to go with Sam on this one.
The second one?
Yeah, either the red onion or mm-hmm the blooming onion.
Yeah.
Although I want to
blooming onion.
It
does answer it. It's something that does not cry. Because that was part of the clue. It's when you put a knife in me, you will cry, not okay. I.
Well, pigs don't cry. They squeal.
Right.
So there is a difference.
No, I'll get you that. But that's why the Asian one has to be ruled out. Because I'm pretty sure they would cry if they were stabbed.
Are you sure? Maybe they're robotic sure Asians women. No.
Oh, that's a whole different story. That's not what this says, though.
All right, Scott?
So, yeah.
I'm going to go with the onion bloom one. That is pretty creative.
All right.
Okay, so. Baroness? Onion bloom.
If you were paying attention, killer. It's
fine.
Three for the onion.
Fine.
Three for the onion.
Sam wins.
Okay, so Samiesa, you get 1,000, which is great because I was already on here.
But he wins. 1,500 points tonight.
Yeah, racking them up to 4,006 points.
Oh.
All right.
On that note.
On that note, it is 11:01. Baron will be up next.
It is.
Thank you all for hanging out with us. Scott, thank you for hanging out with us
coming
back, even
indeed
though Skype tried to, you know, assassinate you.
It wasn't Skype, it was Porkchop.
We know that.
It's always Porkchop.
You
control the internet down in Hawaii, right? With the cables.
Allegedly.
You know, the intercontinental cables.
Allegedly.
To Japan.
Allegedly.
That's
it comes
what
in a glass
doing
bottle.
He's standing there on the beach just like unplugging it and plugging it back in, you know? Unplugging it, plugging it back in.
He'd be the kind that would like try and tie it in a knot like a garden hose.
Look, check out Porkchop's response to my ruling out his decision.
Nice. I'm so
fired.
Nice. Anyway, and on that true. Note.
Yep.
You can catch Scott and Porkchop, assuming their friendship survives this this chat war, Sunday night on Far Afield on our YouTube live channel. That's youtube.com. Is it slash live first or slash Rivalcast Media first? I don't remember.
YouTube.com/RivalcastMedia/live.
There we go.
Yep.
So you can catch them Sunday night for Far Afield. You can also catch... I forget what I was going to say there. Screw it. You can catch them at RivalCon, though, because they're going to be there. Woohoo! In their hats. I'm excited.
Make MySpace great again.
Make MySpace great again.
If you haven't picked up your tickets, they are still available on our Eventbrite page. If you go to RivalCastMedia.com on the... I don't know if we have the button up yet.
Brain fart. No.
Damn it.
No, I don't think we do.
Yeah, I think it's
serious. All right, well, it will be shortly.
It's I'm just imagining the MySpace great again. Shit. We don't win anymore. We don't win anymore on MySpace.
We're going to make MySpace great again. Like it was
before.
We're
going to be winning
great
so
again.
Much.
After
we're
the show.
We're going to win so much.
I've won so many MySpace accounts. It's unbelievable.
Tom's going to friend everyone. He's a friend
he's
of
a
mine.
Very
Tom,
good friend
Tom
of mine.
Is a good
he's
friend
a friend of
mine.
Of mine.
He's always been nice to me.
Ev's a friend of mine. They're friends of mine.
End it now. End it.
Baron's it's up beginning. Next. And from all of us here at Rivalcast Media, cheers.
Adios, mofo.
I deny all allegations.
You know you slept with them.
You can't start rumors about yourself and then deny the allegations. Oh my god.
Didn't.